John Lennon's Imagine is a monstrosity. It's a moral, musical monstrosity. In every, it is the cave troll of all that is good and holy. I mean, it is the worst thing that ever was created. The reason I'm bringing it up is because 2 days ago was the anniversary of John Lennon's assassination. Very sad. People shouldn't get killed. And so everybody decided that we're going to replay Imagine. This is the single worst song in human history. I mean, this sucker makes Justin Bieber look like Beethoven. This is, it's pretentious, it's garbagey, the morality that it spouts is just spew, it's moral spew, it's worse than that. It's actually, it's not just nonsensical, there's a sense to it, there is a sense, but it's so deeply immoral and deeply evil, and yet it's put over this kind of pretentious, these long pretentious piano chords, and him singing meaningfully, and anybody who believes the crap in this song, you should never have any sort of conversation with them. It's a waste of your time. It's a waste of your brain power. I am not a censor. The song should exist. But if I were a censor, I would take every copy of this song and I would take it to a bonfire and I would burn it because it's a terrible song. There are certain words even I won't say here. It is a garbage. So we'll play a little bit of it. And then I'm going to take the screen that we're showing it on, I'm going to hurl it through a window. So we'll play a little bit of this garbage. Oh, pretentious piano chords do it. God, I can't even get through the first two bars of this thing. Isn't for you, buddy.
It's easy if you try. No hell below us. Above us, only sky.
What he just said is the most immoral thing you could possibly say. Imagine all the people living for today. That's basically what we have. Okay, imagine all the people living for today means you don't plan for the future. It means you don't care about your kids. It means you don't care what happens tomorrow. It means you don't care about anybody else. You just care about you. Okay, this is the most selfish morality possible. If all the people lived just for today, they would screw everything in sight and kill all their enemies. That's what would happen if everybody lived for today, because what happens tomorrow doesn't matter. If there's no punishment, if there's no reward and punishment in this life or any other, then all that matters is what is good for me right now. Okay, it's a deeply immoral philosophy that's being preached over this pretentious garbage piano music. I mean, one of the things I hate about the Beatles, honestly, is I actually like trained musicians, and the Beatles can write a melody. There's no question. They can write a catchy hook. Okay, none of them knew how to read music. Call me an elitist. For me to call you a great musician, you have to know how to read music. Okay, I wouldn't call you a great author if you don't know how to read. Okay, but we'll continue with this because there actually is some substance and depth. I think this is the entire Democratic Party. I think this is the entire American and European left. I think this is their morality in a nutshell. And I think they believe that it's beautiful and it is the ugliest morality that you could possibly conceive of.
No countries.
No countries.
It isn't hard.
The next stanza there, no religion. Religion is the cause of all the world's ills. Right. Communism and atheism murdered 100 million people in the century he was writing this. They were busy murdering people in China right as he was writing this garbage. Okay, this is such depraved morality. There's no countries. There's nothing worth killing or dying for. Really, how about like the torture of children? Is that worth killing or dying for? How about the murder of 100 million people? Is that worth killing or dying for? Turns out that in your happy-dappy little land here, where everybody is just wonderful and joyous. This assumes a goodness to human nature that just does not exist. The left assumes that all people inherently are good. All people are not inherently good, and anybody who's ever met a child knows this. Seriously, children are innocent, but they're not good. Everybody assumes that kids are good. Kids are not good. Kids are selfish. I love my daughter. She's wonderful, but she wants what she wants. And if she doesn't get what she wants, she fusses and she cries and she lashes out because she's a kid. Kids are just baby humans, right? Humans are all like this. Humans are not all good and they're not all bad. They are capable of both good and bad, but mostly human beings are not civilized. That's why civilization is necessary for human beings. You have to have cultures. You have to have morality that is taught. If you just left everybody alone in a field, like in primitive times, everyone would kill each other. The murder rate in primitive societies was enormous, enormous, and nothing was developed because there was no civilization and there was no religion. This sort of noble savage nonsense that John Lennon was preaching from the most highly civilized portion of human civilization up to that point in history, it is amazing that all these people live off the fruits of a civilization that is absolutely contrary to their values, and then they suggest that if they just rip away the civilization, that nothing will change. I mean, honestly, I should just dismiss this because the guy married Yoko Ono. I mean, that alone, I should dismiss him. But we'll go one more stanza of this before I hurl myself through a window. Let's finish up with John Lennon. Imagine on the what was this? When did he die? John Lennon, 78, something like that. It was before my time. But on the anniversary of his death, we're gonna make fun of the worst song ever written. So here we go.
But I'm not the only one.
That's the problem. He's not the only one.
I hope someday you'll join us. And the world will be one. Imagine no possessions.
Here we go. Full scale comic. In this giant house, by the way. He's standing in a giant ass house. Can. Need for greater hunger.
A brotherhood of man.
Brotherhood of man that has never existed and never will.
Imagine all the people sharing all the world you
God, this is so childish. And there's your bonus.
I'm a dreamer.
Okay, we can cut it there. So this final push toward no possessions. Honestly, this is actually being promoted by the left today. And there was an article in The Nation yesterday, J.A. Meyerson writing in The Nation says we should just abolish private property. We should just get rid of it. Because when the Wampanoag, this tribe, met the Pilgrims, and the Pilgrims had claimed their land, the Indians came across the land, and the Pilgrims said to them, this is our land. And the Wampanoag said, wait a second, we don't do that sort of like land ownership thing. And J.A. Meyerson says, well, weren't they right? We still don't have a good reason why we shouldn't just share the land. I have a good reason why we shouldn't share the land. It's called several thousand years of no human development and then Western civilization. That's why we should not share the land. Private property ownership, the idea of labor, the idea of owning what you produce, is one of the greatest goods ever discovered in the history of civilization. We would all be hunter-gatherer, nomad peoples with no history. And we'd all die at 30 if it weren't for human civilization and private property ownership and the incentive that suggests that you own what you produce. Hey, but none of this makes any difference to these people. It's deeply immoral, but it's such childish philosophy. And it bleeds all the way down to the kiddies. I mean, this really is something that you would hear from a third grader, but leftists think it's so deep. They think stuff that seven-year-olds say is just the depth of what humankind is. And it really is evil, okay? You should not take your moral advice from small children. You shouldn't, but that's what this is. Okay, when my daughter is 5, I expect that I'll probably hear this from her, and I'll have to inform her life isn't fair and people do bad things. Right? Those two premises alone destroy everything John Lennon is talking about. Life isn't fair and people do bad crap. And as soon as you acknowledge these two basic facts about the world, none of this makes any sense. But I'm telling you, the entire left buys into this. And this is the happy world that it would be if it weren't for us evil Republicans and our evil reality that we bring with us. It really is quite sickening. So, that's the thing that I hate for today. The good news is that I think that reality intervenes. Every time this is tried, reality intervenes. That's the good news and the bad news, because the bad news is that when reality intervenes, usually tens of millions of people die for stupid garbage like this, and will if we allow the left to win. So what I'm calling for in the Republican primaries, let's consolidate around somebody who is not Donald Trump to stop Donald Trump, But let's do it before we get to some sort of brokered convention with all the elites figuring out for the rest of us. I don't like elites figuring out anything for the rest of us, whether it's John Lennon or Karl Rove. I'm Ben Shapiro. This is the Ben Shapiro Show.